Hi, everybody. I'm Robbie Robertson. The 1982 season started right here at Owen Field in Norman on September 11th. Sooner fans had high expectations. Oh, there were some question marks on offense, but the Sooner defense had excellent credentials. The 1982 schedule would be a tough one, but OU head coach Barry Switzer and his staff were confident the Sooners could survive the non-conference battles and once again beat Nebraska for the Big 8 Conference Championship.
It was almost 90 degrees on September 11th when the West Virginia Mountaineers came to town to take on the Sooners. It appeared OU was going to run West Virginia right out of the state. On the second play from scrimmage, Steve Sewell broke off right tackle and picked up 46 yards. OU went 80 yards in seven plays and got on the scoreboard when Weldon Ledbetter went up the middle from 4 yards out. Later in the first quarter, quarterback Kelly Phelps scored from 6 yards out, and OU was in front 14 to nothing. Those were fleeting moments of glory because West Virginia came back with 20 second quarter points. At the end of three quarters, the game was tied at 27. West Virginia quarterback Jeff Hostetler had an excellent day passing for more than 300 yards and 4 touchdowns. With 8 minutes left to play, Hostetler hit Wayne Brown for a 9-yard touchdown to put West Virginia up 34-27. The Mountaineers went on to beat Oklahoma 41-27 in the season opener. On September 18th, the Sooners traveled to Lexington, Kentucky for their first road game of the year. OU was the much better team and beat Kentucky 29-8. OU scored on their second possession, covering 62 yards in 6 plays. Sewell got the first score as he outran everybody from 23 yards out. The defense contributed to the Sooner scoring. Midway through the second quarter, defensive tackle Bob Slater caught Kentucky quarterback Randy Jenkins in the end zone for a safety. The Sooners led 9-0 at halftime. OU quarterback Kelly Phelps got hurt in the first quarter, and sophomore Danny Bradley guided the Big Red the rest of the day. Late in the third quarter, split end David Carter got loose on a reverse for 42 yards down to the Kentucky 15. Three plays later, Bradley went around the right end for 6 yards and the touchdown. OU was in complete control, leading 15-0. Kentucky had to go to the air to try and get back in the game. But the Sooner defense was equal to the task. Darryl Sanji picked off a Jenkins pass and returned it 40 yards for another score. OU intercepted Kentucky 4 times. The Sooners left the Bluegrass State with the victory and were heading home to take on the Trojans of Southern Cal. Oklahoma had a stadium full of concerns heading into the Southern Cal game. The Sooners' offensive line was in terrible shape physically, and Coach Switzer was concerned about how his defense would play against the punishing running game of the Trojans. But it would not be the run that beat OU. For the second time in 3 weeks, it'd be the pass that burned the Sooners. Overall, the Oklahoma defense played well. Southern Cal could manage only 61 yards on the ground. All the scoring took place in the first half. Southern Cal got a first quarter score when Sean Salisbury hit John Kamana from 9 yards out to lead 6-0. In the second quarter, Southern Cal went to the air again. Jeff Simmons ended up on the receiving end of a 67-yard scoring play. Southern Cal won 12-0, and for the first time in 16 years, the Sooners had been shut out. It was time to make some changes.
A record of 1-2 is not exactly what the Sooners had in mind for the first three games of the 1982 season. The Oklahoma defense, with the exception of the West Virginia game, proved they could play. But the Sooners were still experiencing the growing pains of that young offensive line. Changes would be made, and the Sooners would go 7 straight weeks without a loss. The resurgence started in Ames, Iowa, against the Iowa State Cyclone.
I'll be back with more Oklahoma football in just a moment.
It's a widely known football axiom. If your offense is unproductive, your defense is going to have to stay on the field too much, and if that happens, you're asking for trouble. The Sooners did not need any more trouble. Trying to get a young offensive line to mature in a hurry was troubling enough. So Coach Switzer and his staff made a change. They installed the I formation on offense to go with the wishbone attack. The first time we saw the new formation was against Iowa State.
The new I formation did not make the Sooners an overnight success, but it did give OU the opportunity to hand the ball to the two best running backs on the team, Stanley Wilson and freshman Marcus Dupree. On the Sooners' very first possession, they marched 92 yards in 15 plays all on the ground. Wilson got the touchdown from a yard out, and the Sooners led 7-0. Wilson rushed for 97 yards on the day. Freshman Dupree had not seen a great deal of action in the first three games, only 12 carries for a measly 20 yards. He carried the ball 13 times against Iowa State and picked up 62 yards, but there would be better days down the road for Marcus Dupree. Oklahoma beat Iowa State 13-3. The defense turned in another stellar performance. They held the Cyclones to 103 yards rushing and 170 yards total offense. With a Big 8 conference victory under the belt, it was time for Oklahoma to get ready for their annual war with Texas in the Cotton Bowl. There are few college rivalries that match the OU-Texas game. The 1982 version on October 9th in Dallas was everything a great game should be. Oklahoma struck first. On his second carry of the day, Dupree got around the right side and raced 63 yards for his first collegiate touchdown. The marvelous one from Philadelphia, Mississippi, was on his way to a 96-yard rushing day and was beginning to display the form that made him the most sought-after high school recruit in the nation a year ago. Texas had little success on the ground. They tied the game by going to the air. Robert Brewer to Herky Walls for a touchdown. The Sooners marched right back, going 80 yards for the go-ahead score. Wilson got his second touchdown of the year on a 3-yard run. Texas got a late field goal, and at halftime, Oklahoma had a 14-10 lead. While Wilson and Dupree were supposed to be the workhorses for the Sooners, fullback Weldon Ledbetter was the shining star on this day. 20 times he carried the ball, and 144 yards were gained. It was the best day ever for Ledbetter. His 59-yard romp early in the third quarter put the Sooners in front 21-10. It was a 21-16 game in the fourth quarter. Ledbetter blew up the middle from 15 yards out to give Oklahoma a 28-16 lead, but the Longhorns were not through. Brewer hit Walls again, and with 11 minutes left to play, Oklahoma had a 6-point lead. The Oklahoma defense did bend, but they did not break. John Blake caused a fumble. Kevin Murphy recovered to stop a Texas drive with 6 minutes to go. After a Dupree fumble, the Longhorns got it back at their own 33. The Oklahoma defense held again. With 90 seconds to play, the Sooners faced a 3rd-and-11 situation from their own 29. Oklahoma needed a first down badly. Quarterback Kelly Phelps picked up one more yard than he needed, and Oklahoma was able to run out the clock. They beat the Longhorns 28-22.
After the Texas game, the Sooners had a record of 3-2 with the meat of the Big 8 Conference schedule staring them right in the face. There were some questions to be answered. Would the offense continue to improve? Would the defense be able to hold up? The answer to both those questions was yes. Kansas, Oklahoma State, and Colorado were about to find out just how good the Sooners could be.
When the Sooners went to Lawrence, Kansas on October 16th, they put together their best rushing day of the year, and Marcus Dupree served notice to all of college football he came to play. Dupree touched the ball for the first time with 7 minutes and 12 seconds left to play in the first quarter. 11 seconds later, he had run 75 yards for a touchdown. Oklahoma rushed for 556 yards on this day. Dupree got 158 of those yards on just 9 carries. Oklahoma built up a 24-0 halftime lead. It was no contest. Dupree's 13-yard touchdown run in the third quarter made it 31-0. Dupree would get another touchdown in the fourth quarter on a 7-yard run. Oklahoma won 38-14. Kansas rushed for 100 yards. It would be the first of 3 straight weeks the Sooners' opponent would not gain more than 100 yards on the ground. The Sooners returned home the next weekend to play Oklahoma State. The Cowboys brought Ernest Anderson, the nation's leading rusher, at 208 yards per game. But the Sooner defense was ready, and Anderson gained just 59 yards on 20 carries. His longest run of the day was 9 yards. Dupree would gain 83 yards on 16 carries and score 2 touchdowns. His first one came from 30 yards out on Oklahoma led 6-0. A Cowboy field goal cut the lead to 6-3, then the Sooners got a break. Weldon Ledbetter fumbled, but Kelly Phelps got the right bounce and went into the end zone to give Oklahoma a 13-3 lead. In the third quarter, the Sooners got another break. Michael Keeling had to punt deep from his own territory. Stanley Blair left the ball on the ground. Mitch Bryan recovered just 12 yards from the end zone. 3, Dupree running plays got the job done, and OU led 20-9. Final score of the day came in the fourth quarter. Freddie Sims scored from 6 yards out, and Oklahoma beat Oklahoma State 27-9. It was on to Colorado, and the Sooners won big, 45-10. Colorado held a 7-3 lead until midway through the second quarter. Dupree fielded a punt and outran everybody, 77 yards to pay dirt. Colorado was able to hold Dupree to just 53 yards rushing, but the Buffs could not stop Freddie Sims. The sophomore from Tucson ran for 109 yards on 17 carries and scored 2 touchdowns. The Sooner offense did not get all the glory. The defense harassed Colorado quarterback Randy Essington all day. 31 times Essington would throw the football, and 17 times he would find a receiver. But 4 of those receivers wore the wrong jersey. White Drain picked Essington off twice. All-America Rick Bryan got an interception. Sophomore Keith Stanberry turned his interception into a touchdown. When Oklahoma football returns, we'll take a look at the games with Kansas State, Missouri, and Nebraska. On November 6th, the Sooners were home to take on Kansas State. They are usually the patsies of the Big 8 Conference, but not this year. Kansas State head coach Jim Dickey received national publicity when he redshirted 8 starting seniors in 1981 to make sure Kansas State would be good in 1982. Kansas State was good enough to get to a bowl game this year. They were not good enough to beat Oklahoma. Oklahoma did not do much the first three times they had the ball against Kansas State. OU had only 33 yards total offense after their first three possessions. Kansas State led 3-0 until late in the first quarter. Marcus Dupree went off right tackle and did not stop until he had covered 80 yards and scored his 8th touchdown of the year. It would be another banner day for Dupree as he rushed for 118 yards and scored twice. Kansas State turned out to be a much improved team. The Sooners only led 14-10 in the fourth quarter when K-State quarterback Darryl Dickey threw a pass intended for Eric Mack. For the second week in a row, Keith Stanberry stepped in front of the throw and returned it 41 yards for a Sooner touchdown. OU went on to beat Kansas State 24-10. After Kansas State, the Sooners were home again the following week to play the Missouri Tigers. The Big Red Machine was hitting on all cylinders as they rolled up 508 yards total offense and hammered Missouri 41-14. The Tigers would get a first-hand look at Marcus Dupree, who turned in his best effort of the year. Dupree had help. Stanley Wilson put the Sooners on the board first with a 10-yard touchdown run. Wilson rushed for 85 yards against Mizzou. Quarterback Kelly Phelps also got in the act as he ran over people on his way to a 38-yard touchdown run. Leading 14-7 in the second quarter, Steve Sewell scored from 31 yards out and OU had a 21-7 lead. At halftime, it was a 21-14 ball game, but for the third week in a row, the opposition would fail to score in the second half against the OU defense. Missouri was held to just 86 yards rushing. There was a memorable event in the Missouri game. Phelps threw a pass to tight end Johnny Fontanette. It was good for a touchdown. It was the first reception ever for Fontanette, and the first and only touchdown pass of the year for Oklahoma. In the fourth quarter, Dupree got loose for another long gainer. He broke a play for 70 yards and a touchdown. Dupree ran right over Raymond Hairston, then outran the fastest man on the Missouri team. Dupree finished with 166 yards on 19 carries. With that effort, Dupree set a new Oklahoma rushing record for freshmen with 756 yards, and he still had another game to go. The stage was set for Oklahoma and Nebraska. As usual, the winner of that game would go to the Orange Bowl as the Big 8 Conference champion. OU and Nebraska met on November 26th on a very cold day in Lincoln. For the 21st straight year, either Oklahoma or Nebraska was going to win the Big 8 football championship. For the sixth time in 20 years, both teams entered the game unbeaten in Big 8 conference play. Barry Switzer against Tom Osborne. The game was nationally televised. The winner of this game would go to the Orange Bowl. The loser would go to the Fiesta Bowl. One broadcaster described the scene as two heavyweights pounding each other for 60 minutes. It was an accurate description. Nebraska scored first as Turner Gill bolted 14 yards for a touchdown. OU would tie it up on a 2-yard run by Dupree. It was all even at the end of one quarter. The Sooners took a 10-7 lead on a 24-yard field goal by Michael Keeley, but the rest of the first half belonged to Nebraska. A touchdown run by Doug Wilkening put Nebraska up 14-10. A 14-yard blast up the middle by Wilkening again would give the Cornhuskers a 21-10 halftime lead. Oklahoma scored on its first possession of the second half as Dupree raced 86 yards for a touchdown. Dupree rushed for 149 yards on the day to give him more than 900 yards for the year. Oklahoma was forced to throw the football, and OU would not have much success through the air as Nebraska beat the Sooners 28-24. The loss to Nebraska left the Sooners with a regular season record of 8-3, but the season's not over yet. OU will play Arizona State on January 1st in the Fiesta Bowl in Tempe, Arizona. The Associated Press final regular season college football poll has Oklahoma ranked 12th in the nation. Much of the Sooners' success this year can be attributed to freshman running back Marcus Dupree. I'll visit with Marvelous Marcus in just a minute. It's been an incredible year for number 22, Marvelous Marcus Dupree. He set a new single-season rushing record for freshman at OU. He was named Big 8 Conference Offensive Newcomer of the Year, made the All-Conference team, second-team All-America. Marcus, what of your accomplishments surprised you in 1982?
Well, it surprised me a little bit. Like I've been saying all year, I was just expecting to contribute to the team and just help the team out the best way I could. And all this All-American polls and all this stuff was really surprising a lot.
Now you have to deal with that for three more years, Marcus. They're going to expect 1,000 yards next year, then 2,000.
Well, that's great because it makes me work harder. And it just makes me look forward to next year.
Did you feel like a freshman?
Well, at first, before I started making my long runs, I kind of felt like a freshman. I had to get used to the system and everything. Now I just feel like I've been here a couple years now.
Is
first three ball games, not a great deal of playing time for me. Is that difficult?
Well, at first, it was kind of hard. And it was hard for my mother to take, and she wasn't used to it, and I just had to wait my turn.
But it all turned out pretty well, didn't it?
Yeah, it was good.
You certainly did provide Sooner fans a great deal of excitement this year. Is there any particular game or any particular play that sticks out in your mind?
Well, I guess the Texas game, the first long run that I made of the year in the first touchdown. I was looking forward to my first touchdown in college ball, and I guess that probably is the main thing.
What comes next for you, Marcus? Did you have any goals when you first came to Oklahoma?
Well, the goals that I had planned was to go to Miami and win the Big 8 Conference Championship and make all Big 8. I made all Big 8, but I didn't make it to Miami, so I'm satisfied for this year and everything.
It's not a disappointing season for you?
Not really.
What about next year? Do you set loftier goals for next year?
Well, next year my goal would probably be about the same, win the Big 8 Conference, get all Big 8, all first team All-American, be in the bid for the Heisman Trophy, try to win the National Championship.
Thank you, Marcus, and best of luck to you. Marcus Dupree had an excellent freshman year for the Oklahoma Sooners, and now Sooner fans are in hopes a little of that Marcus magic will show up in the Fiesta Bowl.
So clear to me, you can do magic.